My name is Ahmet Icduygu. I'm a professor of political science, and also I'm attached to the sociology department at Koç University Istanbul. Also, I'm directing the research, migration research center at the same university. Perfect. I'm working on migration issues for the last 25 years. Yeah. So several factors contributed to Turkey became a kind of a country of immigration transit, but also I shouldn't forget that after the collapse of communist regimes, Turkey became a kind of area where many of the people from Eastern Europe and the from Russia, Ukraine, Central Asian countries, they came and they started selling their labor in informal labor market. We call this circular migration. They are irregular migrants. They are coming without work permit, but staying in Turkey in certain industries like domestic help or tourism, they work and go back again to their own countries. So there are different types of flows going on from the neighboring countries.
Based precisely on that, how do you see the efforts from Turkey to make these immigrants feel like home in the integration process of becoming them? A part of Turkey's society. You talk about perceptions and the general population perceptions about the immigrants from Syria. How do you see these efforts or the work that is the Turkish government doing?
Okay. Well, when we look at the settled conventional immigration policies in Turkey, which were designed and formulated in the 1920s with the logic of nation building process, Turkey often prefers those people with the Turkish origin, Turkish-speaking people. So from those years, in fact, particularly from Balkans, Turkish-speaking and Muslim population, time to time they moved to Turkey from 1930s, 40s, later on. So in that sense, the immigration arrangement is, in fact, a bit biased towards the Turkish minorities. So when these new immigrants come to Turkey, Turkey was not so ready because, as I said, the different political developments pushed them to come to Turkey, like the refugees, political changes. Since Turkey was a kind of, Turkey played two roles. One is that the Turkish economy developed particularly last 20, 30 years. Some of them, they found employment in Turkey, so in certain sectors. The others used Turkey as a transit zone. So not all of them, in fact, staying in Turkey. And this became a big issue between EU-Turkey relations, particularly transit migration, but not only recently, 2015, earlier, since the mid-1990s. So in that sense, what I can say that the Turkish administrative system or legal system of governing the whole migration issues was not ready enough to deal with this immigration. But it developed a kind of, they made the ad hoc arrangements for these incoming migrants. Only through the EU-Turkey relations, because the EU-Turkey, when the Turkey tried to becoming the member to the EU, that process helped that our legislation change. I just mentioned, the 2013 law. In practice, Turkey became a kind of country of immigration, but this is often the case. In other countries too, often the countries, they are a bit reluctant to accept that they became the country of immigration. But ad hoc arrangement and reality itself brought this picture to Turkey. But with the arrivals of the Syrians now, both society and the government start to understand that Turkey becoming a kind of country of immigration.
Now, in terms of Europe, we have seen in some countries in Europe there's a rhetoric against immigrants, even in those countries in which the population is declining. How do you see, what's your opinion about this rhetoric against immigrants?
Well, I think that around the world, particularly last two, three decades, first, probably different political trends developed. I mean, recently we are talking about these xenophobic trends in the politics too, populist politics, anti-populist ideologies. So political parties, in fact, started gaining a kind of power out of this reaction of the people. Those states start to becoming a kind of inefficient in terms of dealing with the migration. So on the one hand, through the globalization and other developments, I think the mobility increased. mobility of different kinds. The other problem here is there are different types of mobilities and mobility of students, mobility of labor, mobility of the other tourism, etc. When the people see this, this large number of people coming from different cultures, different communities, as we observe in the history, this show the public shows reaction. I think we should not underestimate the role of the media also contributes to the this rhetoric. So this media on the one hand, public opinion and politicians, and that creates a kind of negative environment to deal with the migration issues. And this happens also in many parts of the world.